Hello everybody, my name is Evelyn Borta and I'm back with a new video and with a topic today that I think it's the reason, the root, and at the same time the consequence of the distortions in our human minds, in the human consciousness as well, and in our society, and that is the New Age spirituality, which is nothing else but an upgraded version of the organized religion that used to be super trendy a few decades ago. So organized religion has been upgraded to a more free-spirited, more open-minded version of it, and it has been replaced by that, and that is New Age spirituality. But it has brought forward the same distortions as religion used to have, but in a different form. So this is what I want to talk about in today's video, and why I think that many people are perceiving spirituality not as a way of being in the world, as an awakening to one's consciousness and one's truth, but rather they are perceiving it as a trend, as a symbol of prestige, and why I think that it can be just as toxic and unhealthy as organized religion. So there's a lot to discuss in today's video. I hope I'm not gonna make it too long, but without any further ado, let's get into it. I already made a video about us just completing the Piscean age and moving into the Aquarian age. So we are in a transitional period, so to speak. If you want to check out the video, you can find it there. I will link it. But what I've discussed there as well was that we needed something to believe in. So the Piscean age that lasted a few thousand years was all about believing in God as a separate entity. And we needed gurus and idols that were leading the way, because we did not trust ourselves. We could not use our own discernment about what is good and what is bad for us. So we needed external sources to show us the way forward. And that was the period when many world religions were born. That was this age about the linear thinking, the 3D thinking, the material, believing in hard work, repetition, that we can accomplish anything if we are working hard enough and we are repeating something, we are doing it for a certain amount of time. And we applied this linear 3D human concept to everything in life. And we apply that to religion as well and to God. So these world religions, they created a God that is dysfunctional in that sense, because it's judgmental, it's angry, and if you don't do something that is demanding you to do, then you're gonna be a sinful individual and you have to pay for those sins. So that's why when I hear people that they don't believe in God, they actually don't believe in God that these religions created, and I cannot blame them for that. You cannot not believe in something that is omnipresent. Not believing in God is equal to not believing in your own existence. So what they don't believe in is the God that these religions created, and that is dysfunctional, and those God's actions are full of contradictions. They talk about a God that is loving, unconditionally loving, but at the same time it judges you for certain things. It's like contradiction. That is not God. That is not the prime and infinite creator. That is a God created by humans that has human characteristics as well. So this is the reason why organized religions are failing, because we are waking up to the reality that all these beliefs are contradictory or dysfunctional for us. And these religions pushed this concept of God so far that it has created something that is the opposite extreme of religion, and that is the New Age spirituality. And to understand how these organizations were born, these two extremes, I want to talk about the human consciousness a little bit, which is divided in multiple parts. But today I want to talk about two of these parts, so not to make it too complicated. And one of these parts, which is also like a storehouse of experience, is called the synaptic brain. And the human consciousness that's only in the synaptic brain and is operating from it, that has no credibility for God whatsoever. And it has no ability either to have any creative thought. People functioning from this synaptic brain are logical or intellectual, and they prioritize everything that is material. So they say that, oh, I don't believe in anything that I don't see with my own eyes. They only go with what they know and what they can intellectualize and rationalize. I've been there, I've done that. And the second part of the human consciousness, which I want to talk about, is the multidimensional part. The part that is aware with a divine presence. This multidimensional part in your consciousness is responsible for your creativity, for your intuition, for your passion that is coming from within, and it's not dependent on external sources. So when these two parts of your consciousness, the synaptic brain and the multidimensional part as well, are in balance, then you are a balanced person. Then you are satisfied with life. You are a grounded individual in the material reality, but at the same time, you are connected with the divine presence within you. So that is a balanced individual. Here it comes what I wanted to talk about, why the organized religion and the new age spirituality are both dysfunctional, is because if any of these parts of your consciousness are out of balance, either the synaptic or the multidimensional part, then a dysfunction appears. When this synaptic function and part is out of balance, then the multidimensional part is almost absent. So you don't believe in God, and there's this intellectual arrogance about these individuals. Oh my God, how many of them I have met, especially in these Facebook groups, that they can intellectualize everything, and whoever believes in God or has a different belief system to theirs is stupid. When the multidimensional part is out of balance, then the synaptic part is almost absent. And this is where the new age and the dysfunction of the new age spirituality comes in picture. And these people are floaters. They lack common sense and they lack logic completely. They are totally wrapped up in what is esoteric and what is woo-woo. So how many times I have heard these new age believers saying that all you have to do is thinking positively. All you have to do is, if you want to manifest money, and even this manifesting thing, I have a video on that as well where I talk about these methods and what I think about them. Please check that out, because I don't want to repeat myself. So all you have to do is think positively so you can manifest the dream life for yourself. And in order to manifest money, you have to spend a lot of money. I have been there as well in this belief system that if I go to the supermarket and I don't have any earnings because I don't work, but I have a credit card, and if I feel bad about spending money that's not even mine, then that's gonna attract negative things into my life and I'm not gonna manifest any money. So I used to feel bad about feeling bad about spending money that it wasn't even mine. So I got myself into a credit card debt because I believe that if I don't spend money, I block the flow of money. And what a big BS, honestly. So this dysfunction of this new age spirituality and the law of attraction community is nothing else but the dysfunction of that multidimensional part in you and the dysfunction of your synaptic brain. The human consciousness is a balance between synapse or survival and that which is the part of God, that awareness of that divine presence in you. And that divine part of you doesn't require hard work and repetition for you to accomplish things. You can have a quantum leap or a quantum jump, and you can change your circumstances due to a shift in your consciousness in a second. And that is not subject to hard work. This is just a linear way of thinking, a 3D way of thinking, a human concept. That divine part of you is able to let go, and it's able to surrender because it knows that you have it all. In a non-linear way of perceiving things, you have it all. You just cannot experience all in once because that would be too overwhelming for you. So you have to go through phases. That divine part of you is not fearful. It knows that you are safe and you will experience eventually everything that serves your expansion, and it will happen in divine timing. That multidimensional part of you is multidimensional, is not tied to linear time. And I always like to go back to David Hawking's teachings about the different levels of consciousness, because his teachings helped me immensely in understanding the human behavior. And the human nature, what we call the nature, is just the subject to the level of consciousness that a person is vibrating on. And whenever I think about this new age, positive thinking, law of attraction, spirituality, I always think about that this resonates and vibrates on the level of desire, is below the level of courage. The level of courage is a big turning point in human consciousness, and that is the level from which one's consciousness goes from negative orientation to towards positive orientation. But below the level of courage, everything is negatively oriented. So the level of desire is the level of power, money, and prestige. And that is the level on which the beauty and the fashion industries are built on. According to David Hawkins, this is the level on which people are very easily manipulated and programmed into believing that they need things in order to feel fulfilled. And this is what the economy is built on as well. And this is also the level of addictions and wanting to obtain things in order to feel better about yourself and to feel more appreciated. This is where one individual have overcome fear and they move to the level of desire. And the desire of hoarding things, of obtaining as much money as possible, becomes never ending. So this is when the rat race happens. And I can see that being a theme of these new agers, of this new age spirituality, wanting things, wanting to manifest things, wanting to obtain things. And it's all built on lack. And when one realizes that it has obtained all these things, yet it's still not fulfilled with life, and it's not happy with life, is when the midlife crisis appears, or the dark night of the soul. But that's another topic, maybe another video. So every of these levels has its own purpose, and it serves as a catalyst to move to higher levels. If it wasn't desire, we wouldn't be able to move to the next level. I've been there, I've done that, I had to go through those phases as well, and I used to have that spiritual ego. And that is very common to New Agers. Now, I'm not saying that I was a New Ager someone necessarily, because this law of attraction thing felt always like a missing puzzle for me. I knew that something wasn't really right about it. There's something unhealthy about it. And I knew that positive thinking is not enough. And I think things started to be more clear for me as soon as I understood these levels of consciousness. But then I had to put them in practice as well, and I had to integrate this knowledge. And I can see this in these communities with entrepreneurs. So this new age spirituality, manifestation, law of attraction sort of walks hand in hand with this new age entrepreneurship as well. And unfortunately, it has become a trend rather than, as I said, a way of being. So going back to these two parts of the human consciousness that I talked about, the synaptic and multidimensional, think about the chakras as well in your body. They are the lower chakras and they are the higher chakras as well. So the synaptic part of your consciousness is represented by the lower chakras, and the multidimensional is represented by the higher ones. And in between those is a bridge, which is the heart chakra. That is the energy center of the human body. So if you don't work on your lower chakras to balance out the energies there, to feel grounded in the reality, to feel safe in the material world, and you only operate from the higher chakras, then you can become a religious fanatic or a new ager as well, because you are just floating, you are only operating from this higher part. And same happens when these higher chakras are blocked, then you are only operating from the lower chakras, then you are becoming overly intellectual and you are overly rationalizing everything and whatever is not physical for you, and you cannot see it physically, you don't believe in. And you make fun of people that believe in the non-physical. So that's why it's so important, and there's such a big emphasis put on the heart chakra and to work from there, because as I said, there is a bridge between the lower and the higher chakras. And if that is in balance, that will allow the energy to flow through your body in a very balanced way. So guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope this was helpful. And if you liked what you heard and it resonated with you, then feel free to subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell so you get notified first whenever I upload a new video. Have a great day, have a wonderful week as well, always be true to yourselves, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video.